Good afternoon, YouTube. Today we're going to be making a couple of parts for the second generation Toyota 4Runner or Hilux Surf. And in the US, that's the 1990 through 1995 model years. Those particular vehicles have a torsion bar front suspension and then a coil spring rear suspension. So there'd be a couple of coil springs on each side of the axle. So anyway, the parts we're making today are related to installing a suspension lift on those vehicles. There are a number of options for rear suspension lift on those vehicles. You can go anywhere from a coil spring spacer like this, and this spacer would go under the coil spring pocket on the frame, and then your coil spring would go into this recess, and this would give you about 2 inches of lift with the original springs. There are also several companies that make aftermarket lift springs, and then a third option that people do is that you can take the coil springs off of an FJ80 Land Cruiser, put them on the rear of the second generation 4Runner. And because the Land Cruiser was a heavier vehicle, you get 3 or 4 inches of lift out of those springs, and you can get those at a junkyard for a pretty good price usually. And then of course you've got your shock absorbers that go between the axle and the frame. Those are pretty easy to deal with, but there's two other items here on the suspension that you have to address when you do a suspension lift. So the axle here is held front to back by a pair of control arms on each side. So there's an upper and a lower control arm that go from the frame down to the axle, and that locates the axle front to back and also keeps it from rotating. But then there's this fifth member here called the Panhard bar that goes from the frame down to the axle. And you can see as you lift the vehicle, that bar becomes more and more angled. And ideally, this bar should be pretty close to horizontal. The idea being, if this pencil were that Panhard bar, if you go up and down from a roughly horizontal position, the position of the axle doesn't change very much. You've installed a lift and your bar is at quite an angle. Now as you go down, you can see the end of the bar would be here, and here's where your axle is at rest. So as you go down, your axle moves that way, and what'll happen is this tire, your passenger side tire, will push out to the side and the driver's side tire will move in. And so as you load and unload the suspension, the axle is going to move side to side. It can move so far that one of the things on the 4Runner is right in this area is your gas tank, and right in the center of the axle is the drive shaft. And you could see if that moves over and the suspension compresses to put the drive shaft up here, and then it moves over far enough, the drive shaft can actually hit the gas tank or the skid plate under the gas tank usually. And that's not very good. We make a bracket that lowers this point on the frame down several inches to put the bar into a more horizontal orientation. So instead of pivoting up here and going up and down from that point, it now pivots here and works much more like it should. I've got these basic parts cut out and drilled. So this particular bracket we're making has two positions. It's got a position for 4 inches here and also a position for 3 inches. And the way this bracket works is you bolt the original pivot point through this upper hole, and then you move your Panhard rod down to one of these new bolt hole locations, and that's what lowers the bar down. So I'll show you later how we bend all these metal parts to make this particular bracket. So anyway, that's one problem you'll run into if you install a suspension lift. The other problem you'll run into here, here's a close-up photo. Here's your coil spring. Here's the Panhard bar that's bolted to the axle end. And then here is a rod that runs up to the frame. So this is bolted to the axle. There's this little mechanism bolted there. And what's up here at the other end of this rod, this is what's called the load sensing proportioning valve. This device actually does three things. So one is it's a proportioning valve for your rear brakes. I think these two ports are, one is the incoming brake fluid from the master cylinder, and then I believe this one is the outgoing brake fluid to the rear drum brakes. And so one thing this device does is it lowers the pressure to the rear brakes, because drum brakes take less brake fluid pressure than the front disc brakes, so you need to lower the pressure. So that's the proportioning valve, PV part of this device name. The other part is it's load sensing by this arm. So as your axle moves up and down, if it moves up, that means there's more weight, you're compressing the spring, and if it moves down, there's less weight in the back. And that's sensed by this rod, and then this valve adjusts the amount of pressure going to the rear brakes based on the load. So it's load sensing proportioning valve. And the idea is, if there's a lot of room between the axle and the frame, this valve thinks, oh, there's no weight in the back of the vehicle, I better reduce the brake pressure. Or if you load a bunch of stuff in the bed and push this all the way up, the valve says, oh, there's a lot of weight in back, I can raise the rear brake pressure. But one thing that happens is, if you have your stock setup here and you put a 4-inch lift on here, that valve goes down and it sees that 4-inch suspension lift as if there's no weight in the vehicle. So it's basically shutting off the rear brakes, because it says, I don't want to lock up the rear brakes, turn down the pressure. And what you need to do then is raise this thing up by the same amount of lift that you put on. So we make brackets to do that. We put two holes here to go into those two bolts, and then this happens to be a 4-inch bracket, and then you bolt this piece here with the rod onto the top. And then we also make a 1.5-inch bracket. We also make these with multiple holes, so we can make them like 4, 3, 2-inch. We could put multiple holes in here if you want to be able to dial in your suspension lift. So anyway, we're going to be making some of those today, so I just thought I'd show you those parts. People really get confused by this thing. They forget about this valve. So the main thing you'll see people mention is, gee, I've replaced my front brake pads 3 times and I haven't had to touch my rear brakes at all. Well, the reason you haven't had to touch your rear brake drums and the brake shoes is that they're not doing anything. So of course they're not going to wear out, because you haven't adjusted this sensing rod for the suspension lift you put on a few years ago. So anyway, we got to get busy. I've got parts to make, and we've got to get these orders out. Okay, here we go, YouTube. We're going to bend these inner pieces here. So get down, bring the press brake down to the part, and then we do 1, 2, 3, 4. Give it a little bit of a bend. So there's those parts. And the next ones, we've got to do these. Get these all lined up. There we go. Load down the press brake. bit of a bend. So that's bent it one direction, and then you flip it over, and we've got to raise the brake up. So yeah, here's a little add-on I've done for my hydraulic press jack here, is I put a handle on the release knob. Normally you're supposed to use the end of the jack handle, but I find this handle works a lot better, and we do these both together because then if we press them at the same time, they get the same amount of bend in there. Yeah, I think we're good to go. And now you can see if we flip them over like that, this is the narrow part that fits into the bracket on the frame, and there's space now when we move this out for the end of the Panhard bar to fit in the middle. Okay, we have one bracket in the assembly jig here. So this jig basically duplicates the bracket on the frame of the second gen 4Runner. So this would be your original bolt where the Panhard bar used to go. And we have the little spacer or brace piece inside here. That's what holds the two sides of the bracket apart. And then there's also a heavy wall steel tube in here that the bolt goes through, and then we also put a bolt and a spacer in the bottom here to keep everything from moving around. So next step is we'll tack weld all these pieces together, take it out of the jig, and then finish welding it. So I'll show you what it looks like when we get done here. Got it all welded up down here. We also weld on the bottom, weld around that spacer tube in the middle. And then I've got another one set up. So this is just one of our standard 4-inch drop brackets. So we make these brackets anywhere 4-inch. This one, for instance, was the 4-inch and 3-inch combination version. We can make these down to 2.5 inches. The end of the frame bracket comes to that line right there. So 2.5 inches is about as close as we can get. We also make these in a 5 and a 6 inch long version. And 6 inch is about as much as you can lift the stock suspension without having to do major work, because the other control arms become too short at that point, and there's no way to easily modify those. Yeah, there we go. We've got that one. I've got two more of these to weld up today, and then we've got our LSPV brake proportioning valve brackets. I've got the 4-inch and the 1.5-inch drilled. Okay, and here we got our Panhard bracket. This is the 3-inch, 4-inch adjustable bracket. We have that ready to ship. We supply grade 8 hardware to mount it, so the original factory bolt goes through this hole, and then you use this new bolt to go through whichever hole down here, and this is where your Panhard bar fits in here. You run that bolt in, and then you do need to drill one hole through the side of the existing frame bracket. So you bolt this into place, and then you have to drill through here and then run this bolt in through the frame bracket, and that's what provides the side-to-side force on this. And then we have our bracket for the load sensing proportioning, or LSPV valve, and that also comes with grade 8 hardware. So I got to get these packed up and shipped off to the customer today. Just thought I'd show you start to finish. We cut the material out, mark it, drill it, do the bending. Yeah, so this one's ready to pack up. So I got to get busy, get off to the post office here. Yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comments section down below. And I'll put some of our other Toyota product videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.